If you need to connect wire smaller than 6 gauge to a component like this Garmin power switch, for example, you're going to be using a ring terminal. And teaching you the correct way to crimp these is exactly what I'm going to cover here in lesson number 6 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, I've already talked about how to cut wire, how to strip wire, and how to use heat shrink back in lessons 4.2 through 4.4 of this academy. So in this video, I'm just going to assume you already know how to do all of that and only talk about crimping. Let's get started. What crimpers are best for insulated terminals? So once you have the correct ring terminal size for the wire size you're using, as well as the stud size that it's being attached to, you're going to need a crimper. And insulated terminal crimpers look like this. And the most important part to notice is how the jaws of the crimper look. Insulated crimpers are flat and smooth on each side, and so that whenever we crimp the terminal together, there's no damage to the insulation of the terminal itself. If we were to use uninsulated crimpers like these have a sharp little tooth in the top part of the crimper. And if we were to crimp an insulated terminal, they sort of barely fit in there. And then when you actually crimp it, it sort of damages the insulation a little bit on the sides, and it's just not the right tool for the job. Now I have two insulated terminal crimpers here, and the only difference between the two is the size of terminals that they can crimp. This one has a space for 20 to 18 gauge terminals, 16 to 14 gauge terminals, and 12 to 10 gauge terminals, and this other one accepts 8 gauge terminals as well as 6 gauge terminals. Some crimpers have their wire terminal sizes labeled, and others are color coordinated, and some are neither. I just sort of know what sizes of wires my crimpers are appropriate for, and I can always look back at the instruction manuals for each of them because they're posted online as a reminder if needed. And both of them, they ratchet to help crimp the wire, and then they'll only release once the terminals have been fully crimped to release the terminal. Let me show you how this actually works. How to crimp an insulated terminal. Now I've already pre-stripped off a bit of insulation from this 16 gauge wire. I stripped this back about the same length as the actual metal barrel of the terminal itself. Now I'm going to put the terminal into the color coordinated and appropriately sized jaws of the crimper and just hold it in place for now. Then I can put my wire all the way into the barrel of the connector. And then I can squeeze my crimpers until the crimpers release all the way, like so. And now we have a crimped ring terminal on the end of this wire. Now, sort of alternatively, another way that you could do this, I'm going to strip back a bit of insulation here, is you could just put the terminal right onto the wire, like so, hold it in place, and then put your crimpers in their spot, and then crimp it in the same manner. It's both appropriate ways. I kind of go back and forth depending on how I'm feeling, but try them both out, see which way you like better. Now, once this terminal is crimped onto the end, we need to just make sure that it's nice and secure. So I'm just going to grab and pull on it to make sure that it doesn't come loose. And you should really be able to apply quite a bit of force to the terminal before it comes loose. And here is a table with some values of how much force you should be able to apply to that terminal before it comes loose, and it's honestly a lot. Most of us won't actually have the means to measure this kind of force, but just do your best and make good judgment calls here. Now the larger crimpers here, it's the exact same process, just with, you know, a bigger terminal and bigger wires for that. Same process. So some insulated terminals actually have pre-installed heat shrink on them instead of just a nylon insulator. And if that's the case with yours, which I really like these, you can just hit them with a heat gun for a couple seconds to close up the heat shrink and make it a nice weathertight seal. standard nylon insulated ring terminals, they typically don't receive any kind of additional heat shrink. It would just get too bulky. Can a non-insulated wire crimper be used for insulated terminals? So part of doing these projects yourself means buying the right tools for the job, but sort of here's what I've noticed. For wire smaller than 10 gauge, you know, like we talked about earlier, the non-insulated crimpers, they really just can't be used for these terminals because it does damage the insulation, oftentimes so much so that the metal of the barrel is actually poking through the insulation. Now, for larger ring terminals, like 6-gauge terminals like this, you actually can use this big wire lug crimper like we showed in the wire lugs video. You may just have to sort of dial the pressure back just a little bit by using the adjustable function of this crimper. You know, you're just going to have to be careful to not punch all the way through or tear the insulation, because if you do that, then you have to scrap the connection and start over. Now, we're going to be putting ring terminals on a lot of wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'm just going to assume that you now know how to crimp a ring terminal. Up next, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about crimping PV connectors onto wires for solar panels. Click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.